Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy, a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning, Larry.
Talk about this disagreement about boosters. What are your thoughts?
Well, it seemed like a done deal a couple of weeks ago, especially as the data began pouring out, including from Israel, that a third dose really was quite effective. Antibody levels go up, and the Israelis, who are ahead of everybody in the vaccine process, showed that there was even less disease. But they're just coming up against some old stalwarts that are waiting for even more data. I don't know. I don't really think we need to wait any more data. Just look at what's out there and make a decision today.
A lot of misinformation earlier this week. Singer Nicki Minaj talked about, there's this whole idea of the vaccine causing infertility. Talk about that whole dust up this week and your thoughts on it.
Well, there is absolutely no evidence from anywhere after 2.3 billion people have been vaccinated with a variety of vaccines around the world that there's any infertility involved with any of these vaccines. Now, the Nicki Minaj thing, somebody had swollen testicles. There's other reasons for swollen testicles, including other viral infections like mumps in a person who's not vaccinated. There's other causes for it. I mean, of all these 2.3 billion people, I have never heard of anybody having that.
Okay.
Talk about football. We're seeing packed stadiums, college and NFL. What are your thoughts about that? Do you see this going south, or are we okay with this?
Well, first of all, it's outside, so that's good. But the mixing of unvaccinated people and vaccinated people is a bad idea. And what's happening around the world is those groups are being kept apart. And I think it's just a matter of time unless the pandemic really goes away and quiets down, then it'll be safe. But right now it's not safe.
I think people are, when they see these packed stadiums and we're not hearing about big outbreaks after these seeing, packed football stadiums, they tend to think, maybe why are we being, are we being too overcautious?
No, I mean, Robin, that's always the line we have to walk.
Yeah.
Are we being too cautious? Are we being too risky? With this Delta thing, it's really a different story. And until we get it under control, it's always going to be less risky if you don't mix the vaccinated and unvaccinated people together. Now, maybe a lot of these places, there's enough vaccinated people to create an immunity in the group, plus being outdoors.
Let's take a look at some of the questions, doctor. Here's one. Many of the people currently in the hospital with COVID are unvaccinated. How many of those people that are unvaccinated had verifiable COVID? Also, I hear that being given a COVID vaccine makes you 11 times less likely to get COVID. How is that statistic derived?
Well, if we have another hour, I'll be happy to answer that question. But let's take the first one because that's really easy. When a patient comes in and they get diagnosed with COVID, they're not even diagnosed with COVID until their test is positive. So it's basically 100%. It's easy to do it. Every hospital can do it. There's a test for every size hospital everywhere. Regarding how it's calculated, it's relatively straightforward epidemiology 101. You look at the people who are vaccinated and unvaccinated and look at the rate of infection in each of those groups. And the unvaccinated have actually 5 times more infection, 10 times more hospitalization, and 11 times more death. I mean, it's clear.
All right. Another question. Does blood type of a person make a difference in fighting COVID? Also, have they done a study on the people that have the virus but don't have any symptoms? And why is that?
Yeah, these are good questions. So the blood type actually turns out blood type O does a little bit better, gets fewer infections, but it's a very modest difference. So, in reality, it's not going to make a whole big change in things. And what was the second part of the question there? I'm sorry.
I forgot. Wait. What does it say, Larry?
The asymptomatics.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. So the asymptomatics, we don't know why some people, it's either their immune system themselves or they had a low challenge. In other words, they were exposed to very little virus. And so their body, by the time the virus was replicating, their body had a time to mount an immunologic response. It's a group that's intensely understudied.
All right. Thanks, Dr. Murphy. If you didn't get your question answered, Dr. Murphy answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or go to our Morning News Facebook page and post one there. We'll talk to him again on Monday. Have a good weekend.
Have a great weekend.
Thanks, doctor.